All right, we're here for the junior boys matchup between Deer and the Bears. Getting starting lineups right now. I'll have that list in just a few minutes. This is supposed to be a pretty good matchup from my understanding from coaches. And Deer definitely has some size. Got Baker, Gilmore, Dixon, Carlton, and Chaney starting for the Bears. Starters for the Antlers are Caden Moore. Looks like Law Nichols, Ty Williams, Blake Williams, and Malijah Campbell. Waiting on jump here. Looks like it's Mason Gilmore who will be jumping against Caden Moore. And we're going to get this ball game underway in just a moment. Bears get the tip. It's in the hands of Cooper Baker right now. Gets it over to Dixon and inside to Gilmore. Gilmore gets up a good shot to start the game. Bears get their first points in under 10 seconds tonight. Bears are putting on a lot of pressure already. Cooper got his hands on that one. He had a dribble there that looked like a carry. That was my fault. Had both hands trying to get some things done. I'm sorry about that. Baker trying to dip in there. Carlton gets it out to Chaney and has 3 seconds in the lane called on him in there. It's going to be the Antlers basketball. 5:14 left on your clock. Bears in a full court press here. Baker up at the top. Dixon playing a middle position there. Gilmore trying to stop number 5, Malijah Campbell. Doesn't quite get him stopped. It's 2-2 now. The Antlers also putting on some full court pressure. Baker dribbling through that. Dixon turns, shoots. It's off the mark, but it's going to be rebounded by Carlton. Chaney with the basketball outside right now. Gets it into Gilmore at the free throw line. Makes a great drop to Dixon. One of the Antlers gets a hand on that, and it doesn't quite fall. And the Antlers are going to control possession. Carlton pulling that one out of there after tipping it out. And there's going to be a foul on number 2, Ty Williams. That's going to be the first foul of the game. Antlers again putting on some full court pressure. Chaney with the basketball, looking in at Baker. Baker spins, goes down the right-hand side of the floor. That rebound's got by the Antlers. Baker tips it out on the sideline. It's going to be Antlers basketball across from the table. Antlers get it inside and kick back out to number 25, Caden Moore, who drops a three to give the Antlers a three-point lead with 3:12 left in the first quarter. And Dixon comes down to the other end with an answer. It's tied back up here at Bruno Payette. Chaney with that rebound, and it's pulled away from him by Campbell. Shot by Moore, but it doesn't fall. Chaney gets it to Carlton. Carlton brings it across the timeline. Baker with the basketball, gets it into Gilmore. Gilmore drops to Dixon. Dixon with a bucket. We got a timeout, Antlers. We're going to have a traveling violation on the Antlers as we start this. Chaney with the basketball now gets it to Baker, but he travels before he gets the pass off, and it's going to go back to be an Antlers basketball. That one's tipped out off of Moore's hand. Chaney tries to get it in there. Bout gets a turnover. Baker picks it up on the other side, drops it to Dixon, and Dixon with another bucket. Dixon has at least 7 of the 9 points, and he may have all 9. I'm not sure. And Dixon ties the ball up there. It's going to be Ty Williams across the floor for the Antlers. Brought in by Blake. Ty kicks back out to Moore. Moore off the mark, and we're going to have a pushing call on number 52. I don't have a name for him right now, but that's going to be the second team foul for the Antlers. First on 52 for the night. Baker gets it down to Dixon, and Dixon with another bucket. We're going to call a timeout for the Antlers. We'll be back in just a moment.
Shark Creek Graphics in Gasville proudly supports Ozark Mountain Bears Athletics. Shark Creek is your one-stop shop for custom apparel, hats, vinyl graphics, and drinkware. Open Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Call 870-405-8922 and follow Shark Creek Graphics on Facebook.
We're back. Gilmore does have 2 points. Dixon has the other 9 right now. He's playing a great game so far. Baker with a bucket. 13-5 the score. 1:22 left to play in the first quarter. Zimlick with that steal. Doesn't quite get it to fall on the other end, and it's going to be rebounded by Moore. Passes across to number 52. Again, I'll get a name on him a little later. It's Blake Williams. He doesn't quite get that. Rebound's going to be by Caden Moore, and the foul is going to be on Dustin Carlton. Basket is good for Moore. He's going to be going to the line for one. That's the first foul for the Bears tonight. Right now, foul counts 1-2. And Moore gets the basket to fall. Dixon bringing it down, gets it over to Baker. Baker drives right. He's blocked, and it's going to be rebounded by 52. Foul is going to be on number 23, Dustin Carlton. That's his second Bears foul of the game. Baker with that steal gets it to Dixon. Dixon fakes, goes up. Gets another bucket. Ball goes across to Lane Nichols. And a basket by Campbell. Baker gets it to Dixon, and we've got a travel on Dixon there. Couldn't quite get it under control off of that pass. We have a carry called on Lane Nichols. Zimlick taking it out for the Bears, gets it into Carlton, over to Baker. Baker takes the shot. It's going to go way over the backboard, and we're going to end the first quarter 15-10. We'll be back after this commercial.
At Grice's, we have some homestyle favorites that you're going to want to try for yourself, like our fresh-made biscuits and sausage gravy, our crispy fried chicken, or our hamburger and fries combo made to order how you like it. We know they're good, but why don't you come try them for yourself? Grice's, open every day for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Shark Creek Graphics in Gasville proudly supports Ozark Mountain Bears Athletics. Shark Creek is your one-stop shop for custom apparel, hats, vinyl graphics, and drinkware. Open Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Call 870-405-8922 and follow Shark Creek Graphics on Facebook.
It's going to be Antlers basketball as we start the second quarter. Campbell coming in with it, takes the shot. It's going to be rebounded by Gilmore. Gilmore kicking it up the line to Dixon. Dixon chasing after it. About travels, and it's going to be lost down there. And we got a timeout. We got a timeout for the Bears. Great call there by Middleton. Bears basketball under their own goal. Dixon taking it out. Carlton coming across to that block. Kicks it back to Dixon in the corner. And that's another three for Dixon. 18-10 now your score. Dixon, I believe, with 15 of the 18. Great defense there by Carlton. Staying straight up and not getting the foul there. Baker going down the left sideline, kicks it to Dixon. Dixon doesn't get it to fall. He's fouled as he goes up, and he's going to be on the line for two. That foul's going to be on number three, Blake Williams. That's the third foul on the Antlers for this game. First foul on Blake. Dixon gets his free throws to drop. 20-10, now your score. Baker going down the right sideline. And Baker gets a bucket on the other end. It's 4 points for Baker, I believe. Two for Gilmore. And that'd be 16 for Dixon, who is playing a great game so far. Good kick by Dixon. Zimlick doesn't get it to drop in. Baker picks up the pass out, doesn't quite keep a hold of it. And we're going to have a foul called there. Foul's going to be on Dixon. Campbell making his first free throw. Gets the second one to fall in. Zimlick with the basketball right now. Kicks it down the line to Baker. Baker makes a great bounce pass over to Dixon. Gets another bucket. Late call there. Not sure that I agree with Bell's decision on that one. But he says he dropped him late. That's Gilmore's first foul, fourth team foul for the Bears. And the Antlers pull back within nine, get the steal, and get it back within seven. And Coach Elvis Middleton wants a timeout.
At Grice's, we have some home-style favorites that you're going to want to try for yourself. Like our fresh-made biscuits and sausage gravy, our crispy fried chicken, or our hamburger and fries combo made to order how you like it. We know they're good, but why don't you come try them for yourself? Grice's, open every day for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Bears basketball coming back. They get it to Carlton. It's going to be tipped out of bounds. It's going to stay Bears basketball. Cooper Baker running the length of the floor. He's going to get it up and in. Baker tips that one out. He's going to be rode by number three over there. Blake Williams with that foul. His second, team foul number four. And that's going to bring Lane Nichols back into lineup for the Antlers. Zimlet gets it into Baker. Baker picks it up on the sideline and travels with the basketball. 26-17. Baker with another hand on it, ends up getting the steal, and Zimlet doesn't quite get it to fall, but he's going to be fouled on his second attempt. First free throw is good. Second one falls as well. 28-17, now your score. 3:25 left to play in the first half. Gilmore picking off that steal, gets it to Baker. Baker with a basket on the other end. Bears now leading by 13, still in full court pressure. Dixon with a steal there. Kicks back to Carlton. Carlton gets it over to Gilmore, and Gilmore with a basket. 32-17, 15-point lead for the Bears. And that's a traveling violation on number two, Ty Williams. Great defense there by Carlton. Carlton can sometimes get a little physical and did well there, staying straight up. It's another basket by Dixon. Dixon picking that one on up, and 36-17, Bears now leading by 19, and Coach Rick Napier would like a timeout. All right, we're back. That's going to be a foul on Cooper Baker. Baker got a little bit of body there getting to his defense, and Dixon has the ball now, gets it over to Baker. Baker takes the three. It's a little long, rebounded by Zimlick. Zimlick looking, gets it back to Baker. Carlton looks like he's limping on the knee that was injured the other night. We're going to have a foul under there. I think Kobe Chaney's probably going to be coming in for Carlton. Foul was on number 25, Caden Moore, his first, team sixth. Gilmore's on the line making his first, 37-17. Shot is missed and it goes off the foot of Deer's number 11. It's going to be Bears basketball. Baker with the basketball now, guarded by Williams, and Baker carries the basketball. Defense is getting a lot of hands on basketballs, and that's going to be the second foul on Baker. Pretty. Three-point basket for Deer. 20-37 now the score. Baker is trapped by four. They get it to Gilmore. Gilmore with a basket. Zimlick with that steal. And it's going to be a jump ball right there. That's going to be a travel on Campbell.
It's going to be Bears basketball. Baker with the basketball out top. Gets it into Gilmore. Gilmore looks at Dixon. Doesn't quite have him inside. Chaney with it. Drops to Zimlick, and Zimlick with a basket. And Zimlick gets that foul. It was a good dot for Zimlick coming up. Got it a little late and got some body on him. That's the seventh team foul for the Bears. Seventh team foul for the Bears. It's going to send number 52 to the line for 1-1. Gilmore misses that one, and he fouls on the rebound, and it's going to send 52 back to the line for another shot at 1-1. 20-41, your score right now. It's a basket for Campbell. Again, I apologize. Trying to do a couple things here. Keeping it running. 22-41. Campbell got a rebound and a basket there at the end. But we're going to be back after half. Bears going into halftime with a 19-point lead.
We're back for the second half. It's going to be Bears basketball as we start the second half. 41-22 is your score right now. Nobody in any significant foul trouble so far. Does look like Carlton is on the floor and moving okay. So hopefully his knee is doing okay. They get it into Baker. We're gonna have 3 seconds in lane on Carlton. It's gonna be Antlers basketball. Moore with it from short corner. Carlton gets the rebound. He's going to take it down right-hand side of the floor. And he's fouled as he goes up. Foul's going to be on number 5, Watch Campbell. They're still in some full court pressure. Campbell takes the shot inside, gets it to drop. And Campbell gets the steal and another shot. Campbell with a rebound, then shoots and Gilmore picks that one up. And it's going to be a foul on Campbell. Baker coming down with it, gets it over to Chaney. Chaney doesn't get a hold of it. Baker on the floor after that one. We're going to have a jump ball. Baker with a fast break. Thank you.
Dixon gets a basket inside. 22-point lead right now for the Bears. Ball is tipped away. Carlton hustles down and picks it up. He's going to try to drive. It's tipped back out to Baker. And it's going to be off Antlers, and it's going to be Bears basketball. Basket is good for the Antlers. 20-point lead for the Bears still.
Keegan.
Dixon coming down the right side. Gets it to Carlton. Carlton. Drives, kicks back out to Baker. Zimlick with it. Bears are working it around a little ways. Gilmore drops it in to Dixon. And that's going to be a travel on Dixon. Carlton blocking that one. You can hear some behind the bench, some senior high boys impressed with the block. Blake Williams taking that shot. It's going to be rebounded by Gilmore. Gilmore kicks it down the floor to Dixon, and Dixon doesn't quite get that ball, but he's going to be fouled pretty hard as he tries to go back up with it. And Dixon extends that to a 22-point lead. We've got a travel on the Antlers, number zero. Dixon with a three-point basket. Count the basket for Blake Williams. Foul is going to be on Dustin Carlton, and Williams will be on the line for one. That's Carlton's third foul, team foul number one for the half. That's going to bring Jacob Campbell into the lineup for the Bears. He's going to be replacing Carlton. Baker with the basketball. Gets it over to Dixon. It's stolen by the Antlers in that exchange. Campbell with the rebound, gets it to Zimlick, and Zimlick travels with the basketball. Shot was taken by Campbell. Ends up going out of bounds on the Antlers. Antlers still in full court pressure here. Bears get it into Dixon. Dixon comes down the floor. And it's going to go off of his foot. But he's fouled by Blake Williams. That's Williams' fourth. He's going to be replaced by Deers number 11. Baker with that rebound. He gets it back and fakes and makes the drive, doesn't get it to fall, and Jacob Campbell has the foul on that one. If he didn't have the foul, Baker did. Matt Bell had his choice there on who to call one on. Six seconds left to play in the third quarter, and your score is now 31-51. Bears still leading by 20. Dixon with an easy bucket. Basket for Campbell. Baker picking that one up, doesn't get a shot off. We're going to go into the fourth quarter with the Bears leading by 20. Bears basketball as we come back here. Jacob Campbell with it right there. We're going to have a jump ball. And it's going to be Antlers basketball. foul is going to be on Jacob Campbell. Gilmore gets it to Baker, cutting through. Baker tries to get it over to Campbell and passes it to number 11 for the Antlers. And that's going to be a foul, sending Blake Williams to the line. Foul is on number 54, Gilmore. Pass is stolen by Blake Williams. And we're going to have a travel on Campbell. Went off Dixon, and it's going to be Bears basketball, or Antlers basketball. Three-point shot's good by Blake Williams. And the Antlers are back within 15. That foul is going to send Jacob Campbell to the line. Campbell gets his second one to fall. 16-point lead now for the Bears. Gilmore steals that one, gives it to Dixon, and Dixon gets shot to drop. And he gets to go to the line to complete the and one play. That's the fifth foul on Deers number three, Blake Williams. Bears are now leading by 19. And that was out of bounds on Cooper Baker with 4:29 left to play in the fourth quarter. Bears lead by 19, and it's going to be Deers basketball under their own goal. Baker with that steal. And we're going to have a foul on number two of the Antlers. It's going to be 1-1 for Baker. Baker gets his first one to fall, bringing the Bears back to a 20-point lead. I believe on Jacob Campbell. Nope, that's going to be on Jake Zimlick. That's going to be Zimlick's second foul. Team foul number six. We're going to have a traveling violation on the Antlers. 3:58 left to play in regulation. Baker getting it across the timeline, gets it to Dixon for the three, and Dixon with another three. He's got at least 20 points, and I think he's probably pushing 25 or better at this point. That's going to be out of bounds on the Antlers. Dixon gets it to Baker. Baker pulls it back out, slowing it down. Zimlick with the basketball on the left-hand side. Dixon up top, drives left and turns it over to Deers number 52. It's picked up by Zimlick, who then crosses over the half-court line as he gains possession. And they make a backcourt call there. Got a double dribble on number 52, and it's going to go back to the Bears. With the basketball, pulls up, can't get it to fall. Dixon with the long rebound off the Antlers tip. Zimlick looking to pull it, drives, kicks back out to Baker. Zimlick with it on the right side, looks in at Gilmore there, back out to Zimlick, and Zimlick takes the shot, hits the back of the rim. And through a few tips, Zimlick gets his own rebound before getting it to Gilmore. Gilmore is then fouled on his second attempt. Gilmore doesn't hit his second one. Having a laugh up here, holding our son, and Coach Middleton's wife might have stolen him from us now. So Dixon with the basketball. And it's going to be a full timeout for Middle or for the Bears. Bears basketball as we come back. Baker with the basketball. Gets it over to Dixon. Baker back with it. Dixon picks it up, gets it into Gilmore. Gilmore kicks it back. They don't go out, get that fall. Campbell with the rebound and misses it. And Deere's going to throw it long. End up picking it up under the goal without it going out of bounds. Blocked by Gilmore. Over to Baker. Baker gets it to Dixon. And Dixon with a basket. Gilmore with another rebound. We're under a minute to play in this ball game, and the Bears lead by 25. Zero steals it from Dixon. Dixon gets the rebound off that. Baker with the basketball now. 28 seconds left to play. Substitution timeout here. We're going to get a few in on each side. Bradshaw, Eddings, Grinder. Not sure who all we got. I think Cisco. I'm missing one. I'll find that one here in a minute. Send Logan Cisco to the line. Seconds, 65-40 right now. Cisco hucking that line there. Shot is good, 66-40. Bears leading by 26. And that's gonna be good shot there. 66-43, Bears win this ball game by 23. We'll be back with senior girls action in just a few minutes.
All right, we're ready for some senior high action here tonight. Your starters for the senior girls. Well, I thought I was looking at a starting sheet, and those aren't the same that match up out here. It's going to be Bears basketball to start us off. Gonzalez with it, gets it inside to Young. Young doesn't quite get it to fall. Briley Davis with a three. Yoakum. Yoakum gets it on over to Young, and Young is going to go to the line to shoot two. That foul was on number three, or number one, well, on number three, Briley Davis. Her board changed a little bit there and threw me off, but second shot's good for Young. First one, we had a lane violation. So it's 1-3 right now, the score. They get it inside to number 35. It's missed. Rebounded by Casey. Yoakum getting it down the floor, tries to get it to Young and overthrows Young. Sorry about that. I was getting a name corrected. And we have a foul on this end, number 35, Macy Young. Your starters for the Bears were KJ McFarland, Jalissa Gonzalez, Macy Young, Jordan Jackson, and Tara Yoakum. Four to three, your score now. And that basket's good by Jordan Jackson. We got a timeout, Antlers.
Antlers basketball as we come back. 6-3 is your score. Gonzalez gets that steal, gets it to Young. Young coming down the floor with it. Gets it in, gets it to Jordan Jackson. Gonzalez kicks it back out. Jackson with the basketball. And Jackson with a three. 9-3 now. We got a foul. It's going to be on 35, Macy Young. It's going to bring number 15 into the lineup for the Lady Antlers. That's Olivia Stone. Now your score as the Antlers get that bucket to drop in. Young with a basket. Young gets another bucket. Macy Young gets her third points in a row. That's 6 points here, but third basket in a row. Gets it to Jordan Jackson. Young with the rebound. She's going to be fouled as she goes up with it. Now your score. Stone travels with the basketball. Yoakum gets it across to Gonzalez, and Gonzalez gets a bucket. We're going to have a jump ball. It's going to be Bears basketball. Thank you. goes out of bounds. No, it's on fly. Coming back to the Antlers. Yoakum gets that steal. Davis is missed. Yoakum gets it down the floor to Young, and Young travels with the ball. Young, stay Antlers basketball. Out of bounds on Bradley Davis. Young with another basket. Traveled with basketball, and it's going to go back to the Lady Bears. It's going to go out of bounds on Yoakum. She blocked that shot. Farland is fouled as she goes up with that. Fouled by number 15, Olivia Stone. Jalen Denniston with that last bucket. 21-11 ends your first quarter.
Shark Creek Graphics in Gasville proudly supports Ozark Mountain Bears Athletics. Shark Creek is your one-stop shop for custom apparel, hats, vinyl graphics, and drinkware. Open Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Call 870-405-8922 and follow Shark Creek Graphics on Facebook.
It's Antlers basketball as we're starting the second quarter. Young with that rebound. She carries the basketball as she goes down the court. Going to go out of bounds and go back to the Lady Bears. They have a jump ball. Still Lady Bears basketball. Jalen can't quite get that one to fall. Middleton with it, and she travels. Point basket is good. 24-11 is now your score. Lady Bears leading by 13. Basket. And we got a foul on Middleton. Rebound. Gets it across to Jalen Jackson. Jordan with it now. Yeah. Young on the left side, and she's going to be fouled going up. Foul is going to be on number 22. It's going to be the fourth team foul for the Lady Antlers, the second team foul on Casey. Showing tonight on the board. Three-point basket is good for the Lady Antlers off the glass. And another three. Lady Bears with another three, 34-15. Coach Napier wants a timeout.
Shark Creek Graphics in Gasville proudly supports Ozark Mountain Bears Athletics. Shark Creek is your one-stop shop for custom apparel, hats, vinyl graphics, and drinkware. Open Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Call 870-405-8922 and follow Shark Creek Graphics on Facebook.
.456 left to play in the first half. Bears are leading by 19. Shot is short by Davis. One up with it. Rebounded by Jalen Jackson. Kicks it down to Yoakum. And Young with another basket. 36-15. Bears with a steal there. Middleton with a bucket. On Middleton. And number 35, Aldra Vasquez travels with the basketball. Yoakum with the basketball for the Lady Bears. Gets it into Middleton. Middleton off the mark. Rosenberg steps out of bounds trying to recover that one. Thank you. Young with a basket. Williams misses that one. It's rebounded by Gwinnett. She's then fouled by Jalen Jackson. She's going to go to the line for two. That's Jackson's first foul. Team foul number five for the Lady Bears. Tries to get that rebound and then fouls. That's Stewart's first, team foul number six on the Lady Bears. To get it in, we're going to have a foul inside. It's going to be on red, number 23, Bethany Gwinnett, her first, team foul number five. The second one on Jalen Jackson. Rebound by Bradley Davis. And Davis drives into the lane. Doesn't get the shot to go. It's going to be a jump ball. Middleton puts that one up and in. 42-15, now your score. Bears leading by 27 with 1:43 left to play in the half. On number 22, Casey. It's her third. turnover on the Bears. Picked up by Jade Williams. Three-point attempt. No good by Briley Davis. They try to get it to Jalissa Gonzalez, and it goes through her hands and out of bounds. It'll be Antlers basketball. 40.9 seconds left on the clock. 18-42, your score. Inside, rebounded by Young. Young is pushing it down the right side. Goes up. Count the basket for Young. Foul is on Antlers number 11, Jalen Denniston. Macy Young is on the line for a bonus shot. Misses it. Got a technical foul. On Josh Anna Middleton. Brings the Antlers back within three. It'll be Antlers basketball here off the technical. 6.4 seconds left to play in the first half. Shot is good by number three, Briley Davis. Bears are leading by 21 as we go into half. going to be Lady Antlers basketball as we return to play here at Irvine High School. Bears are leading by 21. Shot is missed by Casey. Rebounded by the Lady Bears, and Young has come down the floor with it. Kicks it to Yoakum. Doesn't get the three-point shot to fall. Jake Williams gets that rebound, and it's tipped away by Yoakum as Williams tries to pass it down the floor. Yoakum driving in. Gets it to Gonzalez. Gonzalez tries to get to Young, who doesn't quite get a hold of the pass. Shot's missed by Gwinnett. Rebounded by the Lady Bears, and Yoakum brings it down the floor. Gonzalez gets it into Young. Young doesn't get it to fall. And it's picked up by Jordan Jackson, then by the Antlers and missed, and rebounded by the Lady Bears. Another missed shot, rebounded by Davis. That's going to go out of bounds on the Antlers. Yoakum will bring the ball in for the Lady Bears. Yoakum with that steal. She's going to push it down the floor. Gets it. McFarland is who I was trying to get to there, and we've got a jump ball in the lane. McFarland with it in the corner, and she travels with the basketball. Three-point basket is good for Olivia Stone. Gonzalez with a made basket. Bears leading by 20. Going to be out of bounds on the Lady Bears. And that's going to bring Bethany Gwinnett into the lineup for Lady Antlers. Jalen Jackson and Josh Anna Middleton back into the lineup for Lady Bears. Yoakum tips that one out. Gets it across, tries to get it to Jalen Dutton, quad hitter. That was a great hustle by Yoakum. Yoakum with another one there, gets it to Young, and Young with an easy basket on the other end, 48-26. And that's going to be a travel on number 23, Bethany Gwinnett. Timeout, Lady Bears.
At Grice's, we have some homestyle favorites that you're going to want to try for yourself, like our fresh-made biscuits and sausage gravy, our crispy fried chicken, or our hamburger and fries combo made to order how you like it. We know they're good, but why don't you come try them for yourself? Grice's, open every day for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Bears basketball as we come back here. Jalen Jackson with it now. Gets it back over to Jordan. Gets it inside to Middleton. Off the mark for Middleton. Yoakum gets it over to Young, and Young gets another basket. 24-point lead here for the Lady Bears. A traveling violation on Olivia Stone. Yoakum gets it inside to Young. Young isn't able to hit it. It's rebounded by Casey. Bethany Gwinnett gets that one out there. Casey turns it over to Yoakum. Yoakum tries to hit Young on the inside, and it goes a little bit over her head. Misses that one. Or Middleton misses that one. And we're going to have a foul on Jalen Jackson. Jump ball is going to be Antlers basketball. Fifty-26 your score. Lady Bears basketball in front of the visitor's bench. Young goes up with that one, gets her own rebound, and she's fouled as she goes back up. Bears leading by 25 right now. Antlers are working around the three-point line. Briley Davis is fouled as she goes up. Foul is going to be on Terry Yoakum. Shannon Middleton with a basket. Steal by Yoakum. And Yoakum with a basket. 28-point lead for the Lady Bears right now. Bears basketball. That'll bring Annie Stewart back into the lineup. Foul inside on number 35, Macy Young. That's going to be her third, team foul number three of the half. Antlers get it inside to Briley Davis. Doesn't get the basket to go. Rebounded by the Bears, and Macy Young's going to be fouled, sending her to the line for two. Gives the Lady Bears a 30-point lead. Be a traveling violation on Jalen Denniston. It's going to send it back to the Lady Bears with 25.5 seconds left to play in the third quarter. That's going to be the end of the third quarter. Lady Bears leading by 30, and we're going to go into the fourth with a rolling clock. Bears basketball as we go into the fourth quarter. Shots missed by Stewart, and it's rebounded by the Lady Bears. Lady Bears basketball as it goes out of bounds. Antlers get that rebound, and it's going to be tipped out by Macy Young. With that steal, and she's going to go the length of the floor. Won't quite get the basket to fall. Yocum dives on the floor after that one. Gets it to Jalen Jackson, and Jalen Dutton get it to go in there. That was a great hustle again on Yocum's part. Get that rebound. Yocum bringing it down the floor for the Lady Bears. Three-point shot from the corner is missed. Rebounded by Yocum and goes back out to Jalen Jackson. And the Lady Antlers come up with that one. Three-point basket is good by number three, Riley Davis. Bears now with 59, and was trailing by 29. That foul's on number 40. Annie Stewart. Going to go off the foot of Lady Antlers number 35, Aldra Vasquez. We got 3:33 left to play in this fourth quarter. We're going to have a foul on Jalen Jackson. Thank you. Basket's good by Jordan Jackson. Casey's going to be going to the line, and she's fouled by number 35, Macy Young. That's Young's fourth foul, team foul number six. We're just under 2 minutes left to play in this fourth quarter. Jalen Jackson with that steal, and Macy Young with the basket. Under a minute left to play in regulation in this ball game. And number 35, Alder Vasquez, gets a basket. Macy Young with another basket. And that's the ball game. 65-34, Lady Bears coming away with another conference victory tonight. We'll be back with the senior ceremony in just a few moments.
because he's filming from his iPad.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's not this camera. Yeah.
I don't think so.
Nope. Damn.
We just transitioned over. I don't know. I just got told to stand here.
This is all about the RC.
Make sure nobody fools me, right? I reckon.
Our first singer is Josh Hall. Josh is the son of Trace and Laura. Josh participated in basketball his 8th and 9th grade year, track grades 7 through 12, and 12, cheer his 12th grade year. Some personal and team awards
All right, we're back here for senior high boys action. Your starters for the Bears: Marcus Bunch, Gavin Freeman, Ethan Brumley. Looking out here, Fletcher and Middleton. Your starters for Deer: you've got 32, Clements. I don't have all of Deer's on here, evidently, but I'll get some of that cleared up a little later. But Fletcher with that one. And the Bears are already off to a four-point lead here, 7:26 on the clock. Bunch with a basket. Timeout, Antlers.
At Grice's, we have some homestyle favorites that you're going to want to try for yourself. Like our fresh-made biscuits and sausage gravy, our crispy fried chicken, or our hamburger and fries combo made to order how you like it. We know they're good, but why don't you come try them for yourself? Grice's, open every day for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Antlers basketball as we return. It's going to be out on the Bears on that one. That three-point basket is by Evan Williams. 3-6 your score. Bears trailing by three, or Bears leading by three with 6:50 on the clock for the first quarter. Bunch, a little long on the shot there. We're going to have a foul under the goal. That foul is going to be on Deer's Clement. Freeman's going to be on the line. Freeman making that second free throw and picking up the steal there. Brumley got fingers on it, and Freeman went ahead and cleaned that up, and we're back across the timeline. Bunch moving it around, gets it into Brumley, then over to Freeman, back out to Fletcher. Brumley with a three. 7-point lead here for the Bears, under 2 minutes into the game. That was on Evan Williams, his first, second foul on the Antlers. Freeman on the line. Makes one of two. Loose ball picked up then by Middleton.
Fletcher for three. Doesn't quite hit it, and it's rebounded by Deers number 12, Campbell. They get it across the floor with some pressure from the Bears. And we're going to have a foul called and outside on 35, Gavin Freeman. It's going to be his first team foul for the Bears. Bears basketball. Middleton up for that shot. Rebound, Jacob Brown. Shots missed by Williams. It's going to be out of bounds. Bears basketball. Gavin Freeman with a bucket. 13-3, your score. A little over 4 minutes into the first quarter. Williams short on that one. Rebounded by Middleton. Basket's good. He'll be going to line shooting one. The foul was on number 42 that I don't have a name for on my sheet right now. I'll get that in just a minute. Evan Milton finishes that with an extra point. Keegan Middleton, not Evan. Kicked out to Bunch. Bunch pulls it up, gets it across. Middleton for three. Short, rebound Bunch. Bunch with a putback. Timeout. Antlers. Antlers basketball as they come down the sideline. Picked up by Gavin there. Kicked out to Fletcher, and Fletcher with a basket on the other end. Bears are leading by 17 right now. And Brumley with a bucket. Thank you. Foul is on Keegan Middleton. I believe that's his first. Team foul number two. Tipped out by Middleton. Kicked back. And Brumley's going to foul him. Brumley ran out there, hustled to try to get that tipped out, and didn't get stopped and fell over him. Bunch steals that one. He gets a basket on the other end. 21-point lead here for the Bears. Stolen by Gavin Freeman. Fletcher is going to bring it back across the timeline. Gavin with another rebound. 33 seconds left. Bears look to be holding it for one shot here at the end of the quarter. Ten seconds. Fletcher from the corner, off the mark. Rebounded and then blocked. Bunch got that one, but didn't get it to fall. And we're going to end the first quarter with the Bears leading by 21.
Shark Creek Graphics in Gasville proudly supports Ozark Mountain Bears Athletics. Shark Creek is your one-stop shop for custom apparel, hats, vinyl graphics, and drinkware. Open Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Call 870-405-8922 and follow Shark Creek Graphics on Facebook.
Basket's good by Dominic Campbell. Fields with the basketball, gets it over to Riddell. Ricketts inside. Walker Collins with that bucket. Sorry, I didn't finish that out. Willis with the ball right now. Gets it to Ricketts, and Ricketts is going to get it across the timeline. Over to Briggs. Briggs looking. Gets it to Fields and over to Ricketts. Ricketts for three off the mark. It's going to be made on the other end. 7-26 is the score now. Collins doesn't get that one to fall. Basket is good by Dominic Campbell. Ricketts for two. Doesn't get it. Collins with the rebound. Gets it to Fields. Willis with it outside. Gets it into Collins. Collins turns. Doesn't get it to go. Rebounded by Column and given to Fields. Miss on the other end. Both sides, there's been an expectation of a foul and no call there. Ricketts with it now. Loses it. Ricketts picks it up, coming back in, kicks it to Willis. Fields from the corner, a little long. Fields. Long. Rebounded by Ricketts. Riddell with it out top. It's going to be missed by Jacob Brown and rebounded by Ricketts. Quentin Willis with the basket. 29-10. Basket by Antlers there. Willis with the rebound, but it's stripped away from him as he tries to go up. Kick back outside. Briggs Riddell gets it across to Fields, and Fields with a basket. Quite get that one to go. that one up. Fields with it now. And Fields with a bucket. 33-12. Baker, Wiseman, and Cisco coming into the lineup for the Bears. Wiseman with the basket. Wiseman gets it out to Collins. Collins goes the length of the floor, doesn't quite get it to fall, but tips it in. Cisco, I believe. It'll be his first. Cisco puts it back up, doesn't get it to go. And that's the end of the first half. We're back here with a 25-point lead for the Bears right now. Coming into the second half. Bears starters coming back out to start the second half. Get a few more minutes of play and time in. Steal by Fletcher. And Fletcher gets an easy bucket on the other end. Didn't turn that camera, put my drink down. Brumley gets it over to Fletcher. Fletcher, another bucket. Ball there. Fletcher with that bucket. Bunch tipping that one out to Fletcher. Gets it to Brumley. Tips back to Bunch. Doesn't quite get it to fall. And Fletcher puts that one in. 45-12, now your score. We're going to have Keegan Ricketts coming into the lineup for the Bears. Middleton gets it out to Brumley. Fletcher over to Middleton. It's going to be tipped out of bounds. Inside to Freeman. Coming down the floor with it. He gets a bucket. 49-12. You got Quentin Willis. Looks like he's coming into the lineup here in a minute. Bucket by Trenton Smith there. Now Middleton for three. That's going to bring Briggs Riddell up to wait to get in, as well as Fields. Looks like about every time somebody scored, we had another substitution come up to get ready. Lead for the Bears, and Collins with the basket. Briggs getting that rebound. Fields with the basketball, gets it back out to Briggs. Collins from short corner. Willis gets a rebound, doesn't quite get it up. Briggs Riddell finishes it. 54 seconds left to play in this third quarter. Collins bringing it down. It's going to be out of bounds on the Antlers. Collins doesn't quite get that one ball. We're going to have a travel. Bell coming across the timeline. 8 seconds left. Ricketts with it. Ricketts pulls it. Doesn't quite get it to fall. We'll go into the fourth quarter with the Bears leading by 44.
At Grice's, we have some home-style favorites that you're going to want to try for yourself, like our fresh-made biscuits and sausage gravy, our crispy fried chicken, or our hamburger and fries combo made to order how you like it. We know they're good, but why don't you come try them for yourself? Grice's, open every day for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Fields with the basketball. Gets it over to Riddell. Wiseman takes the shot from outside. Baker with the rebound and put back. Briggs Riddell with that rebound. Fields doesn't get it to fall. Rebounded by Cisco. Cisco drives, gets it back to Briggs, Fields. And Fields with the basket. Marcus Fields coming down with it, gets stolen. Fields with a fast break. Baskets by Clement. Fields coming down the floor with it. He gets another fast break. Traveling violation. It's going to send it back to the Bears. Field pulls the three. It's good. Marcus Fields coming off the floor. Sure what happened there. May have rolled an ankle after that.
That's okay.
Or possibly cramp, not sure. Wiseman gets it to Collins, and Collins scores. Williams with that basket. Collins doesn't get that one to fall. Rebounded by Trent Smith. Wiseman gets a rebound off that, gets it out to Briggs Riddell. Briggs gets a basket. And a three-point basket for Bobby Holt. Cisco for three. It's good. If I'm not mistaken, that gets all players in scoring tonight. Basket for number 30, and we're going to have a couple substitutions here. We're just under. Well, we're at about a minute 30 left to play in this ballgame. Cisco takes another three. It's off the mark. Rebounded by Holt. Foul on that one. On Wiseman. That's going to be Dominic Campbell on the line. Long pass there, goes out of bounds. 30 seconds left to play. Wiseman with it, gets it. Out, Baker with it now. Baker. Takes the shot. That's going to end the ball game. 76-28.